variance is more of an advanced topic. If you don't understand it, you can still use the t-test. But understanding pooled variance will help make sense of why we do certain things with our t-tests. The pooled variance is really a weighted mean of the two samples' variances. You have two samples. Each sample has its own variance. When you combine the two samples in the t-tests, you need to account for the relative amount of variance. So think of it like this. Imagine that you have a glass of 2% milk and a glass of skim milk, which would be 0%. So if you poured them together, wouldn't you expect to have something like 1% milk, split the difference between 0 and 2? They have different amounts of milk fat, but because the glasses are the same size, you could just average them. But what if you had half a gallon of 2% milk and you mix it with a quart of skim milk? If you poured them together, you would not expect 1%. There's more 2% milk than skim milk, so the combination would be closer to 2%. And that is the logic behind pooled variance. If you were comparing two samples of exactly the same size, then you could just average their variability. But if one sample was larger than the other, then you would need to weight the variability of each sample by its sample size. When we do an independent samples t-test, we need to calculate the pooled variance. The pooled variance is really the weighted mean of the variance of the two samples. To calculate pooled variance, you multiply each group's variance by its sample size. You pool them, and then you divide by the overall sample size. Here's what the equation looks like. Notice each sample size, or degrees of freedom, n-1, is multiplied by its variance. And then the two are added together, and then both of them are divided by the overall sample size. Of course, if you're using software, this will be done for you without you having to ask. But still, it's important to know what's going on behind the scenes. You will use the pooled variance with the standard error of the difference between sample means, usually called the standard error of the difference. The standard error of the difference is the error term for the denominator of the t-test. Let's look at how these formulas work together. You remember the formula for variance. We divide the sum of squares by the degrees of freedom to get the variance. We use n-1 as a corrective factor, since we are estimating a population parameter from a sample statistic. You would calculate the variance of each sample separately, so you would use this formula twice. We create the pooled variance by multiplying that variance of each sample that we just calculated by each sample size, adding them together, and then dividing by the total sample size. The pooled variance is then divided by each sample size. Those are added, and then take the square root of the sum. That is the standard error of the difference. And finally, the t-test is calculated by subtracting the mean of the second sample from the mean of the first sample. That's the mean difference. And then dividing the mean difference by the standard error of the difference. I know that this might be challenging to understand at first, but I think that if you spend a little time with it, it will become more intuitive. Yes, you can still do a t-test, even if you don't fully understand pooled variance. But I think that it is worth the effort to understand the logic behind how a t-test is calculated.